Thanks, Norman. There was a young man tortured in Chicago live on Facebook in recent days, and President Obama denounced it as a horrible crime. He didn't advise looking forward rather than prosecuting the crime. He didn't try to excuse it as possibly having some grander justification. He said there should be accountability. But for 8 years, he has forbidden prosecution of the crime of torture. And he now thinks that a report that is 4 years old should stay secret for at least 12 more years. A lot more can go wrong in 12 more years. That's not good enough. Agreeing with President Obama that there should be no prosecutions for torture was a man named Jeff Sessions. This is not the kind of bipartisan harmony the U.S. public is looking for. As John noted, torture was a felony in the U.S. Code when Barack Obama moved to town. But not only has he refused to prosecute, he's gone through this pretense of banning torture, which convinces everyone it wasn't banned, and convinces everyone it's something a president can do or undo. And so now it's a policy choice, it's not a crime. And you have, as John said, Donald Trump coming to town promising to torture because it's a policy choice. This is the work of Barack Obama, and he can undo it. He can take a serious step for truth and accountability and the rule of law by making this report public now. Senator Feinstein says this report should be made public now. She does not have an ounce of the courage of whistleblowers in this country if she doesn't go ahead and make it public. She can read it on Capitol Hill with complete protection. She can choose to make it public at little to no risk to herself, and she should do so. And people would greatly respect her doing so. She says this report shows torture to be ineffective, contrary to Hollywood myths. Then let's see it. That's important, because this is what Donald Trump maintains, is he's going to come to town and use it because it is effective. And in fact, it's not just ineffective. It's far worse than that. It's been used to generate pro-war propaganda, to generate statements that Iraq is in league with Al-Qaeda. It's been used for sadistic purposes. It's been used for demonizing its victims before the U.S. public. And it's been used to kill. How in the world can torturing people to death be effective? It's been used for human experimentation. This is the ugliness that needs to be exposed so we get beyond this silly debate over whether it's effective or not, which it clearly is not. But we need this document to put that before people. World Beyond War wants to end torture, also wants to end war. And this idea that we will someday have a torture-free war is absurd. If you have a war, you have these atrocities. You have the sort of atrocities we saw reported on at The Intercept this morning from SEAL Team 6. This is part and parcel of any war, and we should get beyond the idea that we can have a war without it. And if we're going to learn the real nature of war, we need to look honestly at what it is. We need to not bury the facts. We need to make this report public.